Everything we've been chatting about over the last six lessons has been very information heavy, but I don't make any apologies for that. The truth is, I wish when I first set out to learn WordPress that I had access to a course like this. There is so much in this that will honestly save you so many headaches. If you've missed some of these previous lessons in this series, do yourself a favor and go back and watch them. Having a clear understanding of what WordPress is and how it operates will give you a great head start. In this lesson, however, hold on to your hats because we're getting into the practical. In a few short steps, I'm going to walk you through how to select your website host, sort your domain name, and give you an example of installing WordPress so you're up and running and ready to begin building your website. Before we dive in, however, let me take a moment to introduce myself. I'm Ryan, and I'm pumped that you've joined us at the Learning Hub. Okay, so let's start with where you're going to host your website. As mentioned in Lesson 6, Elemental recommends a bunch of great hosts, and if you're still having trouble choosing, any one of these will give you a great start. I'm going to choose A2 Hosting for this example. Pretty much all of the recommended hosting options will either come with WordPress installed automatically or give you a simple way to install it with a few short clicks. A2 Hosting do offer a WordPress specific hosting, which would actually make things a little easier. But for this example, I'm going to choose their simple shared hosting so we can take a look at all of the steps. One thing many of these hosting platforms will have in common is a domain name setup step. We touched on this in our last lesson. If you do opt to purchase your domain name from your hosting provider, the process of configuring your domain will be much quicker and easier, but you might not have as many options with the domain name that you want and may pay a premium for the convenience. Let's say I wanted to see if ryansrecipes.com was available. A2 lets me do a search, but as we can see, another Ryan has already grabbed this one. Looks like we're moving on to plan B. The problem here is that we're still no closer to having the domain name that we want. We could try a whole list of different domain extensions, but going through all of these would take forever. Personally, here is where I would head over to GoDaddy to have a look at registering my domain name there. They've got a really cool way of giving you suggestions depending on what you search for. So let's try again, ryansrecipes.com, even though we know it's already taken. No surprises here. However, you can see here on the right, we have an alternative, ryansrecipes.recipes. Now, that's a bit clunky, but it gives me an idea. Let's try ryans.recipes. And there we go. Wow, ryans.recipes is available. So if we're happy with this, I'd simply purchase my domain name from GoDaddy and then go back to A2 Hosting, where we'd select the option, use my existing domain. This would be the same option you'd use if you already had your domain name. For the sake of this example, however, let's say I haven't yet purchased my domain name. But the good thing here is that A2 gives me an option to use a subdomain of a2hosted.com at no additional cost. So this is a great option to get up and running straight away. And as we know, you can always change your domain name later down the track. So after signing up for my hosting plan, I'm given direct access to my client area. So let's click here and see what we have. Now there's a number of things we could explore here, but the most important thing we want to look at is this, our domain name that we've set up and also access to cPanel. cPanel is quite a common control panel you'll find on many shared hosting solutions. It basically gives us a bunch of handy tools and features that are available for you to take advantage of, all included with your hosting. Basic email management, server file access, your database, and DNS settings. But what we're looking for is to simply install WordPress on our hosting. So up towards the top here, we see a bunch of app installers. Let's click through here and see what our options are. In this instance, A2 offers a number of different configurations for WordPress. These would include a bunch of different plugins and configurations, but I'm looking for plain old vanilla WordPress. So we click on WordPress from the sidebar here, hit install, and we use the quick install option. Next step they give us here is where we set up our WordPress admin user. Remember, always ensure you make this as secure as possible. So we enter our username, password, email address, and then hit install. From there, the installation will kick off, and you probably won't even have enough time to make a coffee before it's done. One thing to note here, A2 did give me an error on my first attempt, simply warning me that there were some files on my site that would be overwritten. Because we haven't used this hosting before, these would simply be some basic web holding files. So I was more than happy for the system to overwrite and continue. From here, we're all good to go. WordPress is installed and I can head straight in and begin building my website. So easy, right? If you opted to choose a higher end dedicated WordPress hosting solution, such as Kinsta, Flywheel, or WP Engine, it honestly only gets easier. These systems are optimized specifically for WordPress and make spinning up a WordPress site so easy. So that's it for this lesson. I hope that any reservations you had at all about setting up your hosting or installing WordPress are now completely gone and you feel confident to get in and give it a go. As always, if you haven't yet, make sure you join Elemental's vibrant community and check out the Academy and blog. Catch you in lesson 8.